we have been existing in an altogether different dimension, eternally, absolutely, simultaneously, without being ever born or to die, and that state lies between our deep sleep state and the thoughtful waking dreaming states. This episode of the satsang shows a way to dwell eternally in that supreme consciousness, and the title for this is The Art of Deathless Eternal Living. The technique of living in supreme consciousness 24/7. This is a very, very deeply contemplative inner inquiry which will annihilate eons of past registrations from us. When we wake up from sleep every morning and before going to sleep at night, we should safely sit in a place without leaning the head against any support, eyes closed. Live this technique of the art of deathless eternal living. It is a technique of living in supreme consciousness 24/7 throughout life, and realize the supreme consciousness that is the self. I have been living this, the art of deathless eternal living, through who are myself inquiry within me, and have for the last 52 years since the age of 11 found, like the churned butter arising out of buttermilk, that the supreme self emerging within like a full moon, living with the supreme self, has been the kind of life I have been living. At the same time, eating, celebrating, ecstatically immersing in the bliss of that, and also sharing every bit which I had tasted with the society around me in the form of giving satsangs. Also, I had found on a deeper researching mind that all the objective physical science discoveries about space-time on our earth have tight sync with that of the truth, that is to say, with the existence of the supreme self as the consciousness. And when these objective physical sciences have their base on this inner truth of the supreme self with a concordant note, then only they also shine supremely. And if these objective sciences don't sync with the inner truth, then what happens is the state of existence of this planet, which is evident today. Yes, these objective sciences threaten, compete, envy, instill fear in humanity, and also conflicts and confusions escalate day by day in the society we live. All the more with the so-called spirituality of today, since it has not gone into the origin of ego as inner science, it provocates imagination all around in the minds of people and lead them to more confusions.